Hello! In this video we will take a look at the top 4 audio gear myths, so let's dive right in. Hi, I'm Aviva, and I'm an audio engineer and product manager here at LEWITT. Number 1 on our audio myths list is that vintage equipment is better, and I can think of 3 reasons why someone might think that. There are legendary records that we love, and we tend to glorify things that we don't have, as well as, of course, nostalgia. Yes, some legendary records became legendary due to the gear that they were using. But that's only relevant in retrospect. In fact, many legendary recordings used the most cutting-edge equipment that was available at the time. But the main reason that records became legendary is because there were really creative people involved. Legendary recordings are not about looking back, but rather about pushing boundaries. Do you have a specific record in mind that changed everything? Let us know in the comments. The second reason we might think that vintage equipment is better is because we tend to glorify things we don't have. Now that I think about it, it doesn't even need to be vintage gear in that case.
Yeah, dude, but you know, if I only had that one vintage preamp, you know, the really expensive one, my recordings would be perfect. Blah, blah, blah.
Let's be honest. We tend to glorify things that we don't have because we are lazy. And we're also not willing to admit that we just have to sit down and work on ourselves and our skills. Being drawn to the past can be a cool thing, and there are many collectibles, and some of them can be really expensive. It's also perfectly understandable to want something that just resonates with one's aesthetics. I personally really like to watch my Space Echo sitting on its shelf collecting dust while rising in value. Is it the new Bitcoin? But back to our original question. Is vintage equipment better? When better means technically superior, then the answer is no. Vintage equipment can be superior in the sense that it inspires you. But engineering and science has hugely progressed over the last 60 plus years, and this progress has led to higher precision during production, quality control, and a much better cost to performance ratio. Our next myth, handmade is better. The audio gear sector is full of so-called boutique companies, but what does that mean?
It absolutely doesn't mean anything.
If you have a better definition, please tell us. But jokes aside, boutique companies proudly produce their products by hand from quality components. Some brands are specialized in recreating iconic gear or modifying existing gear, and there are also many brands creating something new and unique. Many people think these products add a sprinkle of magic to your sound. And according to our intel, it's because many boutique companies have a grand wizard hidden somewhere in their basement, soldering stuff. But seriously, the most important factor to determining why a product is good is its design and quality control. And even if you have bad design, quality control always matters, regardless of whether it was built by hand or a robot. One way of doing quality control is to have experienced employees judge every product individually. Another way is to use automated processes. Next myth, tubes equal warm sound. Warm sound. Now, many of you are probably thinking about a glowing tube. And before we continue, I'd like to ask, what does tube sound mean for you? Let us know in the comments. So, does having a tube in the signal chain necessarily lead to a warm sound? Before we answer this question, let's take a blast into the past. Initially, tube technology was intended to sound as clean as possible. Engineering pioneers couldn't foresee the oncoming tube abuse that would ensue in their inventions and remain present until today. Of course, I'm talking about rock and roll. Our research has shown that many people would describe the tube sound as one with tamed highs, warm mids, and a full body. But interestingly enough, the loss of high frequencies often comes from a transformer being in the signal path, and not the tube itself. Tube sound is not necessarily limited to a certain characteristic. It's about how you use the tube, and you can create virtually anything from an ultra clean to really saturated sound. Another audio myth is that the more expensive your piece of gear is, the better it will sound. But what actually makes products expensive? Well, the more manpower there is involved, the more expensive it gets. Workforce is still one of the most cost-intensive factors for business, and that's one of the reasons why handmade products are more expensive than their mass-produced counterparts. Then there are also quantities. When a manufacturer can only produce low quantities, they have to increase their margin to cover costs. With large production quantities, they can cover overheads much easier, leading to lower retail prices. If the product uses cutting-edge technology or features, then the product will most likely be more expensive. And then there are also pricing strategies involved, right? Companies use pricing strategies that go beyond all of these factors mentioned to attract different buyer groups. These pricing strategies are heavily based on psychology and the willingness of what people want to spend. All right, that's it for today. What are your top audio gear myths? Let us know in the comments. And it really helps us to keep going if you hit like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Make yourself heard.